What is something people are not ready to hear?
Here's something people might not want to hear. You know what's super embarrassing? Embarrassment. The idea of embarrassment, it's embarrassing. You know what's super embarrassing? Letting a made-up concept dictate how you live your life and whether or not you're going to be your authentic self in this life. That's embarrassing. And I know this may be harsh, but I'm saying it out of love. I'm trying to reframe it in a way that, though it's harsh, hopefully maybe it'll get that, because sometimes you just need to hear it shit in a way that'll click. But don't let embarrassment stop you from living your life. Also, you're weird if you do this. If you're the type where you project that embarrassment, and don't even try to be like, oh, projection comes from a place. I'm tired of people trying to excuse projection. That doesn't make it okay. If you're the type where you project that embarrassment onto those who are comfortable being themselves, are in a place of like they've released themselves from the shackles of embarrassment and they're comfortable being themselves, and you try to project that onto them and be like, stop. Like, you're being embarrassing. That's weird. I don't like that.
What is something people are not ready to hear?
This is more so for eye doctors. You should not be giving an eye exam in a dark room with a bright light on a screen with dark lettering. Nobody sees the world like that. If you're driving down the street and you try to look at a sign and see what it says, the likelihood of it being dark outside with the sign lit up with dark lettering is slim. And what about those people who can't see in the evening or the early morning time? If the lighting isn't right, there's contrast problems. How I've always received eye exams, they never pertain to me in the real world. There are days I go in and I can see a lot better than I normally can see. But of course, when I'm in a dark room with perfect lighting and dark lettering, I'm gonna be able to hone in on what it is that I'm looking at a lot easier than if I were outside with everything else conflicting with the way that I'm seeing. I would just really like to see a change in the way that eye exams are performed.
What is something people are not ready to hear? I'll go.
I love what she said so much. You guys are gonna learn today, unlike in schools. So it turns out the education system is like brand new and nobody really knows what the fuck they're doing. So get this, up until like 100 years ago, schooling was definitely not mandatory and almost nobody showed up. But then they realized people were too stupid to even join the army. So they decided to make schooling mandatory and gave birth to the Ferris Bueller's Day Off dream. Then in like 1926, they didn't even hide the fact that it was for the army anymore because they made the first standardized testing and they literally took the Alpha Army test and just made it into the SAT. Gets even better. The first real degree or study of educating people didn't start until like 80 years ago. And they'll be the first ones to tell you that they've got no fucking idea what they're doing, especially now that we have so much knowledge at our fingertips. The school system's just broken and ass backwards.
What is something people are not ready to hear?
It's always the people closest to you that hurt you the most. Your best friend, your partner, your family. That's why you have to watch them. That's why you have to look for the red flags, no matter how much it hurts, because it's better to see it than to be hurt by them. And the only reason you get hurt by people is because you care. And usually, the people you care about are closest to you. Watch them.
What is something people are not ready to hear?
If you don't do the homework consistently that your dog trainer gives you, you won't see the results that you want. You would not believe the number of times that I've had clients, and don't get me wrong, I've almost like 99% amazing clients, but every now and again, you'll get a client who, you know, I'll give them the tools, I'll show them how to do it, they'll be doing it, you know, I'll make sure that they demonstrate that they know how to do it properly, and then they'll be like, oh, we didn't get any results, and I'll be like, oh no. What, you know, what went wrong? You know, how much did you practice? And they're like, oh, I practiced once. Not enough. I can only do so much in an hour a week with you. So it's up to you to be consistent about following the homework.
What is something people are not ready to hear?
Oh, this is going to be an unpopular opinion. If your bra creates another boob, buy a bigger size.
It's something people are not ready to hear.
The more real whole foods that you include into your diet, the less you have to worry about cutting foods out of your diet.
What is something people are not ready to hear?
Boneless chicken wings are just chicken nuggets.
What is something people are not ready to hear?
Public schools do not teach your child how to socialize. You teach your child how to socialize. And depending on how you teach your child how to socialize is how they'll come out as an adult. Also, kids are not weird because they're homeschooled. That just doesn't make any sense. Because I was a weird kid and I went to public school. I feel like homeschoolers get judged way too much. You don't go and look at public schoolers and be like, oh, that kid is weird because they went to public school. That's not how that works. Everybody has different personalities. If you're gonna judge someone depending on their personality, maybe you are the problem. I guess what I'm trying to say is just be kind.
What is something people are not ready to hear?
That building wealth via the stock market takes time and consistency. You should be holding these, ideally index funds, for at least 5 years. And you want to keep contributing to it. It's not about timing in the market, it's about the time in the market.
What is something people are not ready to hear?
A chemical found in vanilla flavoring and vanilla scents comes from beaver assholes. I know it's disturbing, but the sooner we accept it and move forward as a society, the sooner Yankee Candle can rename their vanilla candle to Beaver Butt. So, think about it.